So good morning once again. In the last class, we have discussed till question number 4, 8.2. Now we will start with question number 5. I hope you were able to understand how to proceed in this question. Still, let's see. In a parallelogram ABCD, E and F are midpoints of sides AB and CD. So we have a parallelogram. Let's draw. Like this. So, A, B, C, D given to us is a parallelogram. So, given A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Second thing they are saying is E and F are midpoints of side A, B, and C, D. So, side A, B, midpoint is given E. Here the midpoint given is F. As soon as we hear this term midpoint, what comes to our mind is midpoint theorem. But we should always keep thinking in our mind that midpoint theorem is always applicable on a triangle only, not on a quadrilateral. So E and F are midpoints. Okay. The third thing is, okay, show that the line segment AF and EC trisect the diagonal BD. What do you mean by trisect? We have seen bisect means the side which divides other side in two equal parts. We have seen diagonals bisect each other. That means diagonal AB will bisect CD in two equal parts. Similarly, CD bisects AB in two equal parts. Similarly, trisect means there will be three equal parts. Anuranjan, Utkarsh, Moksh. Okay, please admit Vaishnav. Okay. Now, we have to join this A and F like this, and this C and then they have joined this diagonal DB also. Now, what we have to prove in this question is to prove that line segment AF and EC trisect diagonal BD. That means we have to prove DP is equal to PQ is equal to QB. So, to prove DP is equal to PQ is equal to QB. Now, class, tell me how shall we proceed in this question. We have some midpoints. If we use converse of midpoint theorem, I guess we can prove this. But for that, we need to understand that which triangle do you see? Class, in this question, we have two triangles that we can use to prove these things. Can you tell me what are the triangles? Bhuvanjot saying CBD. CBD. Bhuvanjot, this triangle CBD will not help you. You have to think of these three sides. These three sides should be in your mind. This DP, PQ, and QB should be in your mind. Which triangles have these two sides? And if you observe, we have got these two triangles. If you observe, we have got these two triangles, triangle DCQ and triangle APB. Yes, Vaishnav, good beta. Piyush saying BCE. BCE. But Piyush, again, this triangle will not help you a lot. You have to think, if I take these two triangles and somehow I am able to use converse of midpoint theorem, I can say that line starting from midpoint of one side going parallel to second side will bisect third side. Similarly, here also we can say line starting from midpoint of one side going parallel to second side will bisect the third side. So in that way we can say DP equal to PQ and PQ equal to QB. So they all are equal. Mok saying BCE and DQC. BCE and DQC. But BCE will not work, na? Mok? Okay. Try to join on time, beta. With the Sony Arjuman. Class, first tell me this thing. Are you able to understand that how I am choosing these two triangles? So, the question now is, we have got midpoints, F. But we don't have this FP parallel to QC. Again, I'm explaining the concept which we can use over here. We can take two triangles and use converse midpoint theorem. Right now, we're just doing the foundation. One second. Okay. So, again, I'm telling. I am taking this triangle above one, which is D, C, Q, and the lower one, which is P, A, and this B. The problem is we have midpoint F on one side. In this triangle DQC, if you observe, we have this midpoint. If somehow we can prove that this line, which is this line FP is parallel to QC, we can say this equal to this by converse midpoint theorem. Similarly, if somehow we can prove that this line EQ is parallel to this line, we can say, if you observe this FAEC, if we can prove it somehow, parallelogram. Yes, class? If somehow we can prove this FAEC a parallelogram, the question will become very easy for us, because then we can utilize converse of midpoint theorem. Please confirm if you are able to understand in which path we are going. Others, please confirm. Piyush, okay. Utkarsh, good. Others, please try. I am trying to utilize converse of midpoint theorem, for which I need two sides parallel. For that, I am thinking of proving the complete quadrilateral parallelogram. Now, that is very easy. Class, that is very easy to prove. Just think, how will you prove AECF a parallelogram? And try to tell me, how will you prove quadrilateral AECF a parallelogram? Okay, Utkarsh saying E is midpoint. Okay. Others, please try. Please try. How will you prove this AECF a parallelogram? First, you will say, as ABCD is a parallelogram given to you. But can we say that AB is parallel to CD? We all can say, as AB and CD are parallel, so their parts, that is AE and FC, will also be parallel. Therefore, AE will also be parallel to FC. No doubts. First thing, opposite side of parallelogram. Second thing, also AB is equal to DC. We can say they both are equal because they are opposite side of parallelogram. Now, if complete AB is equal to complete DC, can't we say their halves are also equal? For that, if you want to show, you can write like this also. This AB can be written as AE plus EB is equal to DF plus FC. Now see, what you want? You want AE to remain and FC to remain. So let's just write this as AE plus AE is equal to FC plus FC, because E and F are midpoints. It is also given to us. Now, can we say It is a parallelogram because if one pair of opposite sides are equal as well as parallel, we can say AECF. Therefore, AECF is a parallelogram because one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. So now the things have become very much clear. You can see triangle DCQ. Just to show you in proper way, I am drawing them separately. Class, I am drawing this triangle DCQ separately, and we can see what to do now. This DCQ. Try to observe. Now we can apply inverse of midpoint theorem. How? Given to us F is a midpoint. We have proved that this FP is parallel to CQ. We have proved this thing in the previous part only, that this complete is a parallelogram. If complete is parallelogram, can we say these two are parallel? So if F is a midpoint, FP is parallel to CQ, what can we say? Plus, please tell, if F is the midpoint and FP is parallel to QC, what can we say? That DP is equal to PQ by converse of midpoint theorem. As F is midpoint and FP is parallel to QC, you can say in triangle DCQ. As F is midpoint and FP is parallel to QC, therefore DP is equal to PQ, because line starting from midpoint of one side going parallel to second side will bisect the third side. This is your converse of midpoint theorem. So we have got the first part, DP is equal to PQ. Similarly, now which triangle we will take? Class, now which triangle we will take for the remaining part to prove? Please tell, which triangle we will take? Now we will take triangle PAB, this lower one. Now see, in triangle PAB, it is like this, having EQ. This triangle is your PAB. A, B, and B. And this is your point E and point Q. Again, same thing, class. We can apply the same process. As E is the midpoint, and we have proved that this EQ is parallel to AP, we can again apply the same theorem, that is converse of midpoint theorem. You can write as E, or in triangle APB, as E is midpoint and EQ is parallel to AP, therefore PQ is equal to QB by converse of midpoint theorem. You have to write the complete theorem. Don't write MPT or CMPT. Okay, write the complete theorem. That will help you to remember the complete statement. Okay, now we know above statement DP equal to PQ, below statement PQ equal to QB. Therefore, from, let me call it equation number 1, and let me call this equation number 2. We already have a connecting link. So from equation 1 and equation 2, DP is equal to PQ is equal to QB. and hence we have proved that the lines AF and EC are trisecting this diagonal BD. Till now, any issues? Anyone? Please confirm others. Okay, Vaishnav saying how. Vaishnav, the last step is simple. When you have proved in the first that DP is equal to PQ, in the second step you have proved PQ equal to QB. Can't you say that these three are equal? Right. Trisect means we had to prove DP equal to PQ equal to QB. In first part you have proved these two equal. In second part you have proved these two equal. And PQ is the connecting link. And that is why I was able to say that these three are equal. Vaishnav? Vaishnav, but please confirm. Okay. So trisect means these three parts are equal. That's it. Now, next question. Question number 6. Show that the line segments joining midpoint of opposite sides of a quadrilateral bisect each other. Here also, little trick is there. If you try to understand, you have a quadrilateral. So let me draw a quadrilateral like this. A, B, C, and D. So given A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. Second thing they are saying is, show that line segment joining midpoint. Okay, so let's take E, F, G, and H as the midpoint. So E, F, G, H are midpoints. We have to prove that the line segment joining midpoints. So let me join midpoint of opposite sides. This is the first line segment that we have got, and this is the second line segment that we have got. We have to prove OG is equal to OE and HO is equal to OF. Plus, we have to prove that line segment joining midpoint of opposite side bisect each other. Now, how will you prove this? Plus, how will you prove HO is equal to OF and OG equal to OE? Utkarsh saying DO, CO. Okay. Utkarsh saying join DO and CO. Okay. Apart from that, okay, Vaishnav, very good. Plus, no, Utkarsh, you cannot prove this quadrilateral a parallelogram. Suppose you try to prove ABCD a parallelogram. Still after that, you cannot say these are bisecting each other. But if you remember, class, if you remember, we have learned in a parallelogram diagonals, class, in a parallelogram diagonals, please answer, bisect each other. But these are not diagonals. If you see, this HF and GE are not diagonals. So, what if I join these midpoints and prove that figure arc or parallelogram? Plus, what if I join these midpoints and get a new quadrilateral and try to prove it a parallelogram? What do you say? Yes, class. So, the thought that came to my mind is, in a parallelogram, automatically, class, the thought that came to my mind is, in a parallelogram, automatically we can say diagonals bisect each other. But the lines given to us were not diagonals. So what I did, I made a quadrilateral new one, this EFGH. And now my thought process is, somehow I have to prove it a parallelogram. Sir, thoughts came to your mind, but how it will come to us? Okay. With time, everything will come to you. Okay. With great power comes great responsibility. Okay. So, class, same thing we have to understand. proving this thing that diagonals bisect each other was not possible in the case of bigger quadrilateral ABCD because these were not diagonals. So what I did is I joined these midpoints and got a new quadrilateral EFGH, and now it is easy for me to prove it parallelogram. How? Because of these precious points known as midpoints. I can utilize this theorem. Class, I can utilize this theorem. Again, the midpoint theorem. Let me join diagonal AC. Now, can you prove this EFGH a parallelogram? Can you prove this EFGH a parallelogram? Class, easily. So the only thing was understanding or trying to understand how can we utilize some property to prove this OG equal to OE and OH equal to OF. The thing was, we had to see a parallelogram making these, for joining these midpoints. So let's start to prove it a parallelogram. Utkarsh, is it okay, beta? Are you able to understand? Yes, sir. Okay. So now our job is to prove EFGH a parallelogram, because after that, this part which needed to be proved is done automatically. And we all know how to prove it parallelogram. You will say in triangle DAC. Class, what can we say here in triangle DAC? Sure proof of. Okay. So in triangle DAC, we can say GH, that is line joining midpoints of two sides, is parallel to the third side, that is AC, and is half of it. Similarly, in triangle, you can say by midpoint theorem, you will not say this thing. You will write the complete theorem that the line joining midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and is half of it. Similarly, in triangle ABC, we can say this EF is parallel to AC and EF is equal to half of AC. Sir, in this chapter, proof of ASA will come just to confirm. ASA? Okay, that proving part. I can't confirm this thing. You have to learn, if you can. Just try to understand how the theorems were proved. Now, we can say as GH is parallel to AC, so let me call it equation 1. Let me call it equation number 2. We can say from equation 1 and 2, GH is parallel to EF and GH is equal to EF. Therefore, this EFGH is a parallelogram. So we have proved this EFGH. Let me make it again. We have proved EFGH a parallelogram. Now, can't we say that this are diagonals of parallelogram? So obviously they bisect each other. Therefore, OG is equal to OE and OH is equal to OF, because diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. So Moksh, when apple fell on the ground, it was Newton who thought why moon is not falling down. Okay. So the people who try to think, they only can think. So you have to just try. Okay. then only you will be able to give some theorems for future generations to come. Now see question number 7. Last hint for you, you can try it on your own. We have triangle ABC, right angled at C. I'm giving you a hint only in this question because time is less. We have a triangle ABC which is right angled at C. This is the right angle given to you. We have to prove a line through midpoint M of hypotenuse. We have midpoint M of hypotenuse AB. From this line, a parallel line to BC, a line parallel to BC like this is being drawn to cut AC at D. So given to us, angle C equal to 90 degree, M is midpoint, and third thing given to us is MD parallel to CB. Now what we have to do is we have to show, yes ma'am, D is midpoint of AC. Class, how will you prove this? How will you prove D is midpoint of AC? By, very good, because we have this thing and this thing. What we can say, line starting from midpoint of one side going parallel to second side will bisect the third side. So by converse of midpoint theorem, we can prove the first part very, very easily. And the second part, we have to prove MD perpendicular to AC. Now, what will you do? How will you prove MD parallel to AC? Perpendicular to AC. You have to use chapter number 6, lines and angles. Plus, how you can prove that MD is perpendicular to AC? Yes. Our aim is to prove this angle as 90 degree. If somehow we prove angle 1 equal to 90 degree, our job is done. We can say MD is parallel to AC. For that, we can say, suppose this angle is 2, 90 degree, and this angle is 1. What we can see here is DM is parallel to CB. That means 2 and 1 are equal. Why? Corresponding angles, yes. So we have utilized the corresponding angle thing to prove that 1 and 2 are equal. Hence, angle 1 is also 90 degree. And we can say DM is perpendicular to AC. That's it. And last but not the least, CM is equal to MA is equal to half of AB. We have to prove in the third part. Now, you can utilize the thing that you are wanting to utilize again and again. You want to prove CM is equal to MA. Now what will you do? How will you prove CM equal to MA? Yes, class. Now you can use your favorite thing that you want to utilize everywhere in this chapter. How will you prove CM equal to MA? You will try to see in which triangle they are coming. And if you see in triangle CMD, CM is coming. In triangle AMD, MA is coming. So we can prove them by congruency, and after that our complete question is done. Okay, so try this on your own and switch on your